Sibyl, this is your English period. I'm your English teacher. I hope you all are well, staying safe at home. Obey your parents, don't go out. Students, you all know that we are studying lesson number 8. I have explained you lesson number 8. Today we will do two things, that is the hard words and the word meanings in the copies, right? Do it in your English literature copies. As I earlier told you students, that today we will do hard words and word meaning in the English literature copy. So write down classwork, put the date, that is 22nd October 2020. Lesson number 8, the old man and the tiger, that is hard words. Number 1 is daughter. Number 2nd is growl. Number 3 is frightened. Number 4 is surprised. Number 5th is loaded. Number 6 is replied. Number 7 is stinking. Number 8 is immediately. Number 9 is spurring. Number 10 is spurted. Number 11 is sticky. Number 12 is began. Number 13 is exclaimed. And number 14 is wound. Number 15 is enormous. I am repeating it again. Number 1 is daughter, D-A-U-G-H-T-E-R. Number 2nd is growl, G-R-O-W-L. Number 3rd is F-R-G-H-T-E-N-D, frightened. Number 4 is surprise, S-U-R-P-R-I-S-E-D. Number 5 is loaded, L-O-A-D-E-D. Number 6 is replied, R-E-P-L-I-E-D. Number 7 is stinking, S-T-I-N-K-I-N-G. Number 8 is immediately, that is I-M-M-E-D-I-T-E-L-Y. Number 9 is spurring, P-U-R-R-I-N-G. Number 10 is spurted, S-P-U-R-T-E-D. Number 11 is sticky, S-T-I-C-K-Y. Number 12 is began, B-E-G-A-N. Number 13 is exclaimed, S-E-X-C-L-A-I-M-E-D. Number 14 is wound, W-O-U-N-D. Number 15 is enormous, E-N-O-R-M-O-U-S. Now, turn the page, then write down the classwork, put the date again, that is 22nd October 2020. Lesson number 8, the old man and the tiger, that is word meaning. Now, we will do the word meaning. Number 1 is energy. Number 2nd is enormous. Number 3 is fault. Number 4 is graces. Number 5 is handsome. Number 6 is sting. Energy means liveliness and power. Enormous means very large or big. Fault means a failure. Graces means polite. Handsome means good looking. Stink means to have a very bad smell, right? Write down these words, 6 word meanings in your English literature copy. Then comes to your homework. Learn the word meanings of lesson number 8, right? Students, learn it. And students, don't write it in your classwork copy. Write it in your diaries, okay? Students, today we have completed 2 exercises, that is hard words and word meaning. So that's all for today. Have a good day. Students, don't go out. Obey your parent. Have a good day, students. Thank you.